In this chapter, we will talk about how to increase our chances in the labor market. Entering the job market is never what we expected. We had some ideas that our parents taught us, and it turns out that they are all outdated. We hear more and more contradictory information, and the confusion increases. From one hand, it is difficult to find a good job. From the other, employers complain how hard it is to find a good employee. What can young people do to make this journey easier? First of all, try to use all the years you spend on your further education right. What does this mean? Learn as much as possible. Try to pass all the years without problems and with engagement. If you have good grades, you can even get scholarships. Interesting internships, student exchanges, science clubs, small organizations. All that is accessible for free. The next step is answering a question: what do you imagine yourself doing in the next 5 years? Let's use an example. You want to be a furniture designer? Find 10 furniture designers you like the most. Find their professional profiles on LinkedIn or their websites. See what their background is. Write them a message and ask for hints. There is a chance someone will reply. Look on the websites with job announcements, see what qualities are required. Also, big companies like IKEA have recruitment events and specifications you can find online. Be interested with your field. Read books and magazines. And at last, but not least, look for internships, even if they are not financially beneficial. There is no better way to learn about work environment than entering a work environment, even for a moment. The last stage of formal education is a perfect time for building natural networking skills. Try to attend lectures, conferences, and parties. Be active in your classes. Enroll on some courses or a science club. Most of recruitments are finalized before the announcement even gets to the job agency. People want to work with someone they know or someone who is recommended and have a good opinion. It is not nepotism. Recruitment is a challenging process, and most of companies' owners just want to hire a person who is known to be professional and good for the job. Someone from your network can hear about the vacancy and let you know. So, let them know you. As it was mentioned before, you should look for opportunities to do something outstanding. You can start from interesting hobby. Being active at science clubs or local self-government organizations. Volunteering. Some organizations will give you an opportunity to help organizing a conference, concert, or other big events. It will make you more resourceful and sensitive. Having work experience. Look for every opportunity to work, not always in your field. Doing even more. Write a blog. Learn new skills, look for business ideas. Find your own path, be an interesting person. Sooner or later, at the job interview, you will be asked to characterize yourself. What are you good at? Which of your features makes you a valuable member of the group? What are you afraid of? What do you need to work on? These are just the examples of the questions that most of the young people don't know the answer to. They have some idea about who they are, but they can't name these features. The first advantage of knowing how to name your capabilities is that you will be asked about it directly on your job interview. It is good to know how to answer these questions to give someone the best picture of who you are. Moreover, this can contribute to making the best strategy of your self-development. You will make effort to improve or hide your weaknesses and highlight your strength and the things you are good at. Long story short, You want to be successful after graduating? See what the mistakes of those who lost are and try not to repeat it. Analyze the behaviors of those who became successful. Examine the market, adapt to it. Finally, be different and stand out.